Today we will be talking about another interesting facet of pharma marketing. In Indian pharma marketing, it's a full of customs and traditions. Here people don't do, or can say people don't ask why you're doing this. Because before him also everybody was doing this. So there are well set traditions in the pharma marketing. And one such tradition is that we were taught that pharma marketing, patient is buyer and doctor is the customer. Means doctor will decide on the behalf of hundreds and the thousands of the patient what medicine or which brand to buy. Patient cannot decide. This chronology was correct also till a few decades back, as patient used to strictly stick to what doctor prescribed. But what has changed now? In last couple of decades, there are three major changes has come. I'll talk about these three changes today. Change number one, see, in 2017, there was a study conducted by OPPI about the self-medication in India. And it was found that almost 52% of Indians are doing self-medication. This means that 52% of Indians were going to the doctor for some ailment and directly going to the chemist and buying the medicine for some other ailment. It does not mean that 52% are not going to the doctors. Another similar study was conducted during COVID time, and this percentage gone up 80-85%. And even if you look at, say, post-COVID point of view, we may say that COVID time it was a little higher side, so that should not be taken. So post-COVID also this may settle something around 70-75%. So 70-75% of people we can assume they do the self-medication in India, which means this patient, for certain medical condition they go to the doctor, and certain medical conditions they treatment directly themselves. Or put it in more layman language, in these cases these patient they have complaint, these patient diagnose them themselves, these patient prescribe for themselves, and they buy themselves and they consume for themselves. It's something like na wakil na appeal na dalil seedha insaaf wo bhi tabartod. So in this case, where so much a big number of the people are buying on its own, and this means the patient cannot be taken for granted, and it's we cannot depend simply on the doctors. We cannot simply, our marketing strategy cannot be directed only at doctor. Now let's look at change number two. The change number two is about the internet. Now public is a Google literate. Many people before reaching the doctor, they Google the symptom. They Google the disease and they Google the treatment also. And rest Googling they do after meeting the doctor. So Google is probably the biggest doctor. And this is the reason why many doctors now put up a slip in the clinic that please do not show your Google knowledge. That is the situation now. So people have developed, apart from that Googling, people have developed some good or bad knowledge about companies as well as medicines also. Therefore, they tend to discuss with the doctor which medicine is prescribing, why is prescribing, and for which company is prescribing, or which good company, bad company. That discussion also they tend to do with the doctor, why doctor writing the prescription. In a way, we can safely say that patient more or less influence of the doctor prescription also. Now a doctor, unless he is very senior doctor, he will not bother, but normally doctor, they do care about the patient sentiments and they tend to get influenced by this patient discussion. Ultimately, patient is kind of customer to them. This clearly means that the patient is no more the same old patient. Now he has his own say in the what doctor prescribe also. So this again a very big change is happening. Now coming to change number three. Change number three is that even after taking prescription from the doctor, this patient, they go to retailers or the pharmacies and they do the independent discussion with the pharmacist. What should buy? Generic or branded? Economical or costly? Good quality or the average quality? Which is, or how to say, 4-drug, 5-drug which is prescribed? Which one is more important? Which is not? Which is prescribed by which indication? So then from the retailer, he do one more level of discussion, and accordingly then patient take the buying decision. And then he has choice also going to whether generic store or normal store or hospital pharmacy, or you can say Janosdi. He has that choice also, even e-pharmacies also. So they buy after due discussion with the chemist. This means that prescription does not mean that patient will buy these medicines or these brand, whatever doctor prescribe. Patient take final call only after due research and due discussion with the pharmacist and sometime with the friends also. So when you look at all the three reasons, we can understand that we cannot take patient for the granted the way we have been taking. And the old theory or the old custom or the old tradition of focusing only on the doctors is no longer universal truth. So today, marketer has to take a patient also into account while deciding their marketing mix or the promotion mix. How it can be done, what can be done, or in such case, we will talk about in some other videos. But today, one thing I would like to conclude that we cannot take patient for granted. And we need to challenge old wisdom and old tradition of the pharma marketing that patient has to buy what doctor prescribe or doctor is the only important. So we need to challenge these customs, particularly when the ground realities are changing or that have changed. So let us relook our promotion mix or marketing mix and have a thinking about it. Thank you, friends, for watching.